Happy day, students. Today I am going to deal with English grammar, direct and indirect speech, part 4. Dear students, already we have seen changing indirect to direct speech, focused on assertive sentence, then interrogative sentence. We have finished up to WH question form. Now we shall move on to yes or no question form. So we shall see. David asked his father if he could buy him a computer. So first step, you see, asked will become said to. Second step, open quotation. Then third step, cancel the word could and write it before you, could you. Okay, fourth step, could present tense, so it should become can. Fifth step, he refers to his father, so it will become you. Sixth step, him refers to David, so it will become me. And last step, seventh step, it is close quotation. David said to his father, can you buy me a computer? So step 1, said to, and step 2, you know, no change. And we have here can. Step 4, then step 5, you. Step 6, me. Dear students, we shall move ahead to imperative sentence. So see the changes. Reporting verb changes as per relationship. Indirect speech, asked means relation, said to, friend to friend. Asked indirect speech means student to teacher. Advised or asked means teacher to students. Directed means passerby to traveler. Advised or suggested means doctor to patient. Asked means patient to doctor. Requested means servant to master. Ordered means master to servant. Inquired means police to thief. Commanded means captain to soldier. Warned or advised means mother to son or daughter. Now let's move on to the positive sentence. Okay, teacher informed the students to submit the notebook the next day. So first step, informed will become said to. Second step, open the quotation and remove conjunction word to. Then third step, the next day will become tomorrow. Then fourth step, close the quotation. Very easy, is it? In imperative sentence, the verb followed by to is called infinitive. To finish, infinitive. To submit, infinitive. Teacher said to the students, finish and submit the notebook tomorrow. Okay. So, step 1 is said to, and step 2 finish, then step 3 tomorrow. Next, we shall move on to negative sentences. Mother advised her daughter not to tear the papers from the book. So, first step, advice will become said to. Second step, open the quotation, change not to into don't in the sentence. Then third step, close the quotation. Mother said to her daughter, don't tear the papers from the book. So, said to is step 1 and don't is step 2 and step 3, the book. Okay, close quotation marks all. Next, request. Anand requested Akash to give him his watch. So, first step, you see, requested should be changed into said to. Then, second step, open the quotation and write please, because requested means you should use please. Third step, him refers to Arnav, so it will become me. And fourth step, his refers to Arnav, it becomes you. And fifth step, close the quotation. So, the answer is Anand said to Akash, please give me your watch. So, step 1 we have seen, step 2, then step 2, please, step 3, me, then step 4, you are closing the quotations. Now, we shall move ahead to exclamatory sentence. Okay, first one you see, exclaim joyfully means you have to use the word ah. Exclaim with joy means hooray. Exclaim sorrowfully means alas. Exclaim angrily means damn it. Thanked means thank you. Apologize means sorry. So, he exclaimed in joy that it was a beautiful rose. So, first step you see, exclaim will become said to. Second step, remove the conjunction word that. Step 3, change the statement into an exclamatory sentence and put exclamatory mark at the end of the sentence. It was a beautiful rose. What a beautiful rose. So, last step, close the quotation. So, answer will be, he said to me, what a beautiful rose it is. So, said to is the first step. And what a beautiful rose, step 3. Then step 4, closing the quotation marks with exclamation mark. Hope you have understood everything. Now we shall move on to the exercises. Rewrite the sentences in direct speech. First one, the teacher told the students that the students had done very well in the test. So what will be the answer? The teacher said to the students, open quotation mark, you have done very well in the test. Students, it's second person, no? So plural, it is you only. Second one, the prime minister said that he was determined to abolish poverty. So answer is, the prime minister said, open quotation mark, I am determined to abolish poverty. Third one, all holy scriptures advise us to do our duty without worrying about the result. So this is imperative sentence. So answer will be, all holy scriptures say, okay, it is in present tense, do your duty without worrying about the result. Fourth one, the teacher asked me whether I was going to join the medical course or the engineering course. Answer, the teacher said to me, are you going to join the medical course or the engineering course? Fifth one, Shyam's grandfather advised him not to waste his time in unnecessary activities. So what will be the answer? Shyam's grandfather said to him, open quotation mark, don't waste your time in unnecessary activities. Sixth one, the headmaster asked the boy what he could do for him. Answer, the headmaster said to the boy, comma, it is ordinary question, okay, what can I do for you, question mark, then close the quotation marks. Now seventh one, the boy replied that he had come to ask him for a scholarship. The boy said, open quotation mark, I have come to ask you for a scholarship, close quotation mark. Eighth one, the doctor asked the patient whether he smoked. So whether or if comes means you have to use yes or no question. So the doctor asked the patient, do you smoke? Then question mark, quotation marks. Ninth one, the teacher asked the students where they wanted to go. So answer is, the teacher said to the boys, where do you want to go? Last one, you see, my friend exclaimed that it was a very beautiful view. So answer, my friend said, what a beautiful view it is. It is closing with the exclamation mark. Next exercise, rewrite the following in direct speech. The happy prince asked me why I wept. See, answer, the happy prince said, why do you weep? Okay, it is an ordinary question. Second one, he told you that he didn't trust you. So he said to you, I don't trust you. Very easy, is it? Third one, she says that she is happy to be there that evening. So here the reporting verb is present tense says. She says, comma, open quotation mark, I am happy to be here this evening. Fourth one, the policeman inquired him where he was going. So answer will be, the policeman said to him, where are you going? Then fifth one, the teacher told the boys to sit down. This is imperative sentence. So answer is, sit down boys, said the teacher. Dear students, we shall see some more exercises, okay, on this changing indirect to direct speech. Okay, so first one, she told her mother that she was going to the market. So what will be the answer? She said, open quotation mark, I am going to the market, close quotation mark. Second one, his friends told me that they would go home the following Sunday. So what will be the answer? His friends said to me, we will go home next Sunday. Third one, the teacher told Mark he had been very regular in his work. The teacher said, open quotation mark, you have been very regular in your work, close quotation mark. Okay, fourth one, Mark told me that he had finished his work. So it will be like this, Mark said to me, open quotation mark, I have finished my work. Fifth one, the teacher said the earth moves around the sun. This is universal truth. The teacher said, open quotation mark, the earth moves around the sun, doesn't undergo any change. Sixth one, he said that she was not going home that day. He said, open quotation mark, she is not going home today, Then seventh one, he asked me if I had brought the pens. He said to me, open quotation mark, have you brought the pens? Question mark, close quotation mark. Eighth one, the boy asked me if that was the place we had visited before. The boy said to me, okay, this is also yes or no question. So it will be open quotation mark, is this the place we visited before? Ninth one, the judge told the witness to tell the truth. This is imperative sentence. The judge said to the witness, open quotation mark, tell the truth. Tenth one, you see, the prisoner begged the judge to forgive him. So begged here means forgive, that is please. The prisoner said, forgive me please. So, dear students, hope you have understood this changing direct to indirect and indirect to direct speech. So, hope you would do well in your exams. May God bless you as you are learning. Take care of your health. So, with this, I finish direct and indirect speech. Thank you.